All right, how's it going, everybody? It is time for September 2017, which means it is finally time for the month that we are dealing with Anniversary 2. We've finally gotten to the point where Anniversary 2 has finally arrived. We now get to we now get to deal with that. So definitely gonna get ready to move on with that. We still have one more Infamous to book first, and I will also say that I know we had a couple of people that we were going to be bringing in. I looked at a couple more people potentially to bring in for the anniversary show, and that should be quite fun to actually get to. So yeah, a lot of surprises, and I wanted this to feel like a big event and make it feel like something really big was happening. So you know, I'm trying to get as many, you know, types of new talent and so on and so forth to get that in here and get all sorts of big matches booked and everything else. As you saw, maybe one of the people there, since Chael Sonnen was technically like an analyst, quote unquote, for Global Force. He technically is in this as a color commentator, and out of the color commentators that I had seen, he seemed to kind of best fit the mold as far as people that I kind of was looking into bringing in. So, you know, he's cheaper, and he's not that bad either. So, you know, feel pretty solid about that. But we do got a book, Infamous 34, that's in 13 days. Let me just advance a couple days and make sure that I could actually get to that point, and that we will hopefully not completely have something too bad happen here while I'm doing this. Also, I'm going to bring something up real quick and then in a side monitor just to check it out. There we go. That Michael Hutter is trouble. Of course he is. I did book him for like one of my early shows. While that's still going on, let's see if I can actually punch this up. Back when I did TEW 2013, let's see if it'll actually show it while it's sitting here loading the game a little bit. Oh, but yeah, I think, what was it, like Infamous 3, maybe it was. What did the history look like for this? Oh, that's right, I had to like redo something, so it only has it to 12. But yeah, I remember it was like 3. It was in front of like 9 people, something like that. Sure, I'm not gonna really use it, but okay. It seems like there's a couple things to check first. Tetsuya Naito left CMLL due to contract expiry. Scorpio Sky sustained a hernia. Well, good. I wasn't planning on bringing him in immediately, so good. Just helps me out. Let's see, contract negotiations. Alright, Katarina Waters. I think I'm gonna push her as a face. I think that's what I was thinking. She's slightly worse. She's still pretty good as face in comparison to heel, but I think there was a couple things I wanted to do with her. And I do remember her kind of new worker name is Katarina Lee. I don't know if that's actually in here. No, just Katie Lee in Winter, so I'll just leave it under Katarina Lee, because that's kind of like her sort of new name, so I'll just leave it as that. There we go. Hang on, I'm just dealing with some stuff here. There we go. I also am just now realizing, because someone had posted into my Twitch, that for some reason Twitch The restream didn't want to work for Twitch, so one second here as I try to reconnect everything. I want to give that a quick test, too, when I'm there. One second. Okay. It's really weird, because the Twitch part of this doesn't want to pop up, but the hitbox part does. And then when it comes to... typing in, I can do it for Twitch, but not hitbox. So, I think I'm going to have to readjust the chat. I thought the Restream chat was going to work perfectly fine, but it doesn't look like it's actually going to work as well as I hoped it would. So, give me one second as I try to get this to work here. Oh, balls. Hang on. Alright, let me see if I can't refresh this. Sorry, I'm having all sorts of chat issues. It's not even on the hitbox version, it's on the Twitch version. So let's see if reconnecting it seemed to do anything. Yeah, this is a real game, by the way. It's a text-based simulator for booking wrestling. Son of a bitch. Hang on one second. I'm just trying to get this... Get off my screen. Ugh, god damn it. Hang on. I'm gonna figure this out. Oh my god. Go away. Drop off. Ugh, balls. I'm sorry. Just one second. This wants to be a pain in my ass. It was working so perfectly fine, and then it just didn't wanna go. All right, let me test. All right, Twitch one is working. Jesus Christ! What a pain in the ass. Hitbox is working. Sweet. Is Brother Nero in this? Brother Nero exists in this universe. I don't have Brother Nero in my promotion. However, I do have Unbroken right now, Matt Hardy. So, I think right now Jeff is charging way too much, or he's got some written contract. Yeah, it's a TNA, it's a written contract. So, no way I can bring him in, and he's out injured on knee ligament damage. Shit, probably wouldn't even mean all that much anyway. He's out for the next 4 months as it is. So, yeah. Brother Nero exists, he's just not here. There. Alright. Alright, sorry. I was just having all sorts of issues, and now it seems to be okay. Senor Benjamin? Probably not. Although, stranger things have happened. In fact, that's why Chael Sonnen is going to be probably my color commentator. Let's see here. I don't have a gimmick for her yet. What can she do? I'm gonna need to probably give her kind of a weird gimmick, because I think that's how I'm gonna be using her. Summon Brother Nero with a violin. Absolutely. Let's do weird face gimmick. I like the fact that, like, Jeff would have knee ligament damage, and he just comes hobbling to the ring because Matt decides to play a violin. Like, he just, like, it's like, wait, we didn't even hire you. Why the fuck are you here? I heard the violin, man. I knew I had to be summoned. Oh, man, what is she going to be? Crazy. She could be crazy. Mystical Oriental. Monster Occult. That's kind of how she was as Winter. Wizard of Odd. Oh, and in honor of Brian Kendrick. Oh, God, what do I want to have her be? Pyromaniac, Psycho, Pitbull. I feel like Mysterious would probably be the best one. So we'll make her Mysterious. Who will prepare the field for Massacre? Let's have Dario Cueto do it. Feel like that's how I'm going to do that one. We'll use one of my cronies. Or the guy who's in charge of the whole thing. Let me take a look at the schedule before I start booking stuff. Alright. Tozawa's gone on that Sunday. The reason why I changed it to Sunday, by the way, is that most of these people seem to be gone on these Fridays that I'm going to need them. And it's not just normal people. It's like the guy. It's like, oh yeah, you know all of you guys that I book? Yeah, you're all deciding to leave me on one day. So I could do Tuesday, but I'll just work without Tozawa for a day. Since when is Jeff Hardy Bray Wyatt? I have no idea. did I kind of make him sound like that? Yeah. Alright. I think we could pretty much make it to the next show. Oh yeah, I did forget to mention with the titles, I did make some makeshift titles. I mean, you can't really see them all that well, but there are championships there as well as a opportunity trophy briefcase. By the way, this is one thing I love about the Restream chat, is that maybe the slight delay or something, someone can ask a question from Hitbox and then someone from Twitch can talk about it. I like that idea that like someone could be asking something through this stream on Hitbox and then someone on Twitch sees it and then they can answer with it. I like that. This is gonna be probably one of my favorite parts about this whole dual stream deal. There we go. I just had to mess with something. Alright, so I think I'm just gonna try to make it to Friday, man. I'm gonna have to try to carry this without Tozawa. But that's fine. He's in a match, but he's not in like, oh my god, the important match of the whatever. So just get through that. Oh no. The Immortal Vader, the recently retired Vader, is the newest addition to the famous Hall of Immortals. 62-year-old's achievements in wrestling are legendary. Oh yeah, they have the Hall of Immortals, which is different than most people's Hall of Fame. The Hall of Immortals is almost like the pro wrestling Hall of Fame. Which, you know, has a lot of great people, and it's kind of cool to see Vader in it now. I refuse to acknowledge you with the double, the double deal there. OVW, JCW production change, the increase there is the professional. That's not going to, like, overshadow my shit, is it? As long as the production... Oh, no, they're upgrading there. Oh, you suck. All right, $1,500 a month and a $500 a show. Oh, no. What is the upgrade? $7,500 a month and $2,000 a show. Fuck, why do you guys got to do this shit to me? I'm trying to spend money on talent, and you're going to have to make me spend money on production values. I think that's going to cost me like an extra 10 grand a month now. Since I do show, with the two shows, it was like, what, 2,500 plus 500? So, I mean, that's an extra 3,000 there, plus an extra, like, I think it was 5,000. So that's like an extra $8,000 that's now being tacked onto my production. Don't see Shark Boy. I think there is a way to actually see like how far into something someone is. Like as far as how far into the Hall of Immortals they are. I forget exactly what it is, but I thought that used to be a thing. You like this? Where can you download? This is Total Extreme Wrestling 2016 at, you can go to graydogsoftware.com. Text-based wrestling booking simulator. At Grey Dog Software, they have a whole tab for like their wrestling, their MMA stuff, basketball, football, blah, 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 their web store. You buy it off them, they give you a little key, like an order ID, and then you paste that order ID after you download the game. There we go. Chael Sonnen, $1,000 in appearance, complete the contract. We're going to wait to bring him in, I think. I think we're going to wait to bring him in until, I think, the anniversary show. So technically I have my second announcer for Eric Bischoff, but I'm going to wait on that. Chael Sonnen needs an assignment. Does he need a gimmick? It says he needs a gimmick. What kind of deal can Chael Sonnen be? Cool, cocky, wholesome? Let's give him a gimmick. Let's see, we'll make him cool, and he's a face. Authority figure, band member, degenerate, happy-go-lucky. Because when I think happy-go-lucky, I think Chael Sonnen. Rebel Rogue. Sportscaster is probably the best way to approach this. Just make him a good old-fashioned sportscaster. Recommended push as an announcer, of course. I just realized, if he's an announcer, I wonder if that means Bischoff is going to take over color. Oh, he's pushed as an authority figure, but whatever. One can do announcing, one can do color. That's cool. What is he at with that? Well, only show announcers. What is Chael Sonnen at? Alright, his announcing is only just below Bischoff. So, yeah, we'll wait until the anniversary show to do this. We have Infamous in 10 days. We still have two more contracts to line up in time for this. So we'll just keep going to the next show until someone else decides to sign with me. Go. Hey, Timefly, how's it going? What's with the Guy Fieri shtick? I've never seen you just pop into my chat with a shtick. It's weird. Oh, there we go. Repairing the battlefield for massacre. Eli Drake. I actually thought about that. Someone spamming Guy Fieri quotes in WoW. Oh, God. Why? It's not even that amazing with, like, Guy Fieri. Nick Jackson, Evolve upgraded theirs. CWFH upgraded theirs. Oh, no. Kushida and Pete Dunne, all signed up to, let me make sure these guys are available. This might not be good if they're doing tours. This might not be good for my, alright. As long as people are, this is the day, no matter what, this is absolutely the day I need people to be here. So I don't give a crap about some of the other nonsense. Just be there. 2,200, yeah, I'll do that. Dude, it's amazing how quotable that entire... I think I've probably watched the final deletion at least five or six times. at least, in full. Delightful! It's an extraordinary xylophone. Gracias. Are you a licensed TNA official?
I don't know if I was gonna have her as a heel or a face.
We'll put heel, and then we'll figure it out. Alright. First off, Michael Hutter. Dumb. Ethan Carter III. Come back as EC3. As far as gimmick, oh man. What can he be? A cocky heel, I assume? Cocky weasel heel. A heel, and then it's either cocky or weasel. Probably cocky. Guy's a little too built to just be a weasel. Let's see here. Can you sing Crypt Official? Chosen One? Can you book your own final deletion?
You must count the pinfall or record the submission. I shall now take this violin. I shall now...
what was it?
I shall now summon the evil enigma with this violin given to me personally by my good friend Antonio Stradivari.
God damn it. Generation Star, High Society. I mean, that's pretty much him right there, was the High Society. That was pretty much his deal. Trying to see if there's anything else. He's an oppressed minority. There's no reason he shouldn't be able to use this gimmick successfully. Can you imagine that? I wanna book oppressed minority straight white men. Straight white men as oppressed minorities. let's see. Pretentious. We'll do pretentious. How about that? I think he could pull off pretentious. Let's see. Then we want... I think she usually just goes by Lisa Marie at this point. I don't want to use, like... if we're going to use Ethan Carter... No, actually... I don't know if she's allowed to use Tara. I don't think she even uses Tara. I'm pretty sure she uses Lisa Marie. So we'll just save that. Pimp EC3. Oh my god. Yeah, the dilapidated boat. It's a dilapidated boat! Oh my god. Dude, that thing is... It's like, to me, it's like Face Off. It's like, it's so bad it's good, and it's so fucking quotable. That's how I see the fun. My favorite image from the entire thing, if I can find it, is Matt Hardy on the lawnmower. Matt Hardy on the lawnmower is probably my favorite image of the whole thing. that's probably the greatest image in the whole thing. It's just Matt Hardy. That one is more sinister. There's another one where it looks like he's almost like deriving pleasure out of it. Like there's the evil version of it, and then there's the one where it looks like he's deriving some sort of weird pleasure out of it. I wish I could find that bit. But yeah, I mean, that was the one where it looks like he's evil. It's like, oh my god, he's so maniacal. Ha ha ha. And then there's the one where it looks like he's just getting off on the fact that he's doing this. Like, that was the one that really got me. Let's see here. Okay, so that's everybody, right? That's everybody. We have pretty much everybody set for the anniversary show. what I'm going to do with everyone per se, I have ideas. There's a couple of them I'm not 100% sure just yet, but we'll probably get to it when we get to it. So we'll just go ahead and get through this here. Let me just save this, and then yeah, we need to get to the show. Make that Matt image in TEW. Oh my god. Alright, you know what? While this is loading, I'm going to try to do this off stream. Hang on 1 second. I'm gonna try to do this. His profile picture. Absolutely, hang on. 1 second. I want to see if I can do this. Oh god, okay. I have the picture for it here. Just a second. TEW, loads and backgrounds. There's the background image. Man, I'm going to have to cut around that, like, lickety-split. Okay. Game's still loading. It's days through, so 1 second here. I still can't 100% see this. Let's see. Is El Pentagon Jr.? I don't know. I have to see. Let's see. Matt Hardy. Lawnmower. I think it'd probably take just a little too long for me to actually cut around. But that'll be something that I'll do at some point. Not to mention he's a face technically in my promotion right now, so I won't worry too much about it. So we'll just let it do its thing there. That'll be something I'll have to do the next for the next time for the next stream. I'm telling you though, after the final deletion, I honestly wanted to come in here and find a way to turn Matt Hardy heel, just so I could have broken Matt. Because I'm like, fuck it, I'll find a way. I'll find a way to have broken Matt Hardy in my game. I'm so glad I decided to get caffeinated drinks before I came home from work. Alright, we're at Sunday week 2. Things need my attention. Oh. Everyone's... Dude! I actually thought about this, actually, just recently, was the possibility of using the extra profit that I get every month to increase the production values, just to see if I can't price smaller companies out of here. He's fixed, Matt, yes. He's glued together, Matt. But yeah, I had this idea of potentially doing that, where I start upgrading certain things. Let's see, that's $1,000 a month. That's $7,500 a month. Oh my god. Yeah, I honestly considered doing that, where I just try pricing people out of their deals. Let's see, auto push. Alright, I need to do... Who do I need to take out of this? Chael Sonnen, there we go. Everyone else is fair game, we'll just move them to what they need to be. There we go. Naito doesn't even technically need to be a main eventer because he's just going to be here for one show. Everyone else should be fine. Of course, EC3 is going to be a main eventer though. Sherman's technically back down to mid card because we got guys like Kushida, Matt Hardy, EC3, Alex Reynolds, like... The main event talent on my show, the supposedly main event of my show, and one of the guys is a mid-carder. Yeah, speaking of Matt, it's Omega. I don't know who owns that. Who owns Omega in this game? David Marquez, head booker of NWA Pro Wrestling. NWA North Carolina. They're technically bigger than I am, which is ridiculous. I don't think they're that huge. That feels ridiculous. Raven was inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame. That is amazing. I'm trying to see if there's anybody else. Like, I don't know. WWE would never... I don't think they'd ever induct Raven into the Hall of Fame. It'd be kind of interesting to hear his story, but I don't think that'd happen. Because I know Raven's a pretty well-spoken guy, but... I do enjoy that much. I don't know if WWE inducted anyone else oddball in here. CM Punk got inducted into the Hall of Fame. The Steiner brothers got inducted. This is all WWE doing this. New Age Outlaws got inducted. It's amazing. Scott Steiner got in on his own merit. Oh my god. I would love nothing more than to see a Scott Steiner Hall of Fame speech. I'd find a way to... I would absolutely find a way to try to make it there. Oh, hey, Rob, how's it going? Welcome. Oh, God. I'm just checking up on a couple of things real quick before I decide to book my show, because... it's going to be a bit of a pain when I start this up. Hi. Alright. Do a quick deal here. Please tell me Tozawa's the only guy that I'm going to be missing here. EC3, which I won't need right now anyway. Pete Dunne. Well, fuck me. Okay. Oh, no. Oh, Ethan Carter III's not going to be there for House of Hardcore. Oh, my God. Oh, what a pain in the ass this is going to be. Everyone's gone for shit. This is not good. Oh my god. Well, this sucks. I'm gonna have to figure it out before... Let's book this show, and then we're going to figure out what day I'm going to make this. Because you've never seen this game before in your life. This is Total Extreme Wrestling 2016. It is a text-based wrestling booker. Raven Suit W. Oh, yeah, I forgot about that, yeah. Raven Suit WWE, that's right. Him and Vito and I think a couple other guys. Yeah, this is a text-based wrestling booking simulator. You get to control a company, book matches, and I've been doing... this is probably like episode 26 or so now. I've been doing this for almost a year now. Starting from like nothing, so it's pretty cool. It's basically like Out of the Park Wrestling, yes, but with... yeah, it's Out of the Park Wrestling. let's see. Hojo's out, Carter's out. Okay, goddammit. So, and... boy, I'm gonna have to work around somebody's schedule here. And I think Tozawa was one of the odd men out. I hate to, cut Tozawa out of the anniversary show, but I may have to. Let me make sure that all got in there. Okay. Scott Steiner's banned from the Hall of Fame ceremony because he threatened... I like the idea that they do that, where they're just like, alright, we're gonna put you in the Hall of Fame, but you can't actually show up. You can just do something from... Tuesday looked good, all you were missing was Big O. Yeah, but he's in one of my ladder matches, man. That's the thing. I have to either sacrifice a guy from one of my ladder matches, or from my ladder match, or I have to sacrifice a guy from one of my singles matches. Crazy Mary, what did she do? She lifted the atmosphere by bringing her cute pet puppy into the locker room. And then told stories about how 45-year-old Dick feels like. I gotta say, I found out about that. I'm like, really? Like, she's like, what, 24 or something? And she's either married or she's been with Badman Pondo, who's in it well into his 40s. And it's just, I don't know why, it just feels kind of odd. I'm just like, 1900 bullshit, but we'll assign this as venue, because we'll use this until we sell it out. Alright, so this holds up to 2,000, they're expecting 1,900. We had 1,500 people last time, maybe we'll have like 1,600 or something, who knows. 31 popularity, so there's a good chance after this show we could end up regional. You prefer to miss EC3 to the Big O? No, I would prefer to miss, it's not EC3, it would be Tozawa. Tozawa is on Thursday. And I know, Tozawa or Big O, I know, it seems obvious that I would prefer to miss Big O. Big O's in one of my big matches, though. So it's either Tozawa, who's in a throwaway singles match right now that I could probably put on a different card, or one of the guys in my ladder match, which technically, and Big O's kind of been built as a guy who would be, you know, he would sit there, and he's been kind of built as the guy like, oh shit, he can win this. To be fair, based on how I'm going to be booking the next few months after this show, I kind of need the Big O to be in this match. All right, so the Go Home show. Let's see here. First, we'll start with the history. What did we start off with? We started off with a match last time, so we'll start off with what do we want to do? Pondo was her trainer. They are married. Okay. I didn't know if they were still married or whatnot, and Pondo was her trainer. That just seems... I don't know. That just feels odd. Like, you just... Like, if you look at Madman Pondo, and then you look at Mary Dobson, and you're just like... I mean, good for him. Good for him, certainly. It just seems odd. Because, let's see, Madman Pondo, Mary Dobson. Yeah, it's the... I can't really get a picture right away, but it's just odd, almost, but, I mean, still, good for him. let's see here. Alright, so what do I want to start off with? We do need to start off with... Let's start off with an angle. We need to do that first. So... Let's do Dario Cueto coming out here. Dario comes out to announce that... A battle royal for the main event for the last spot in the opportunity. Oh, God. In the ladder match. How about that? Opportunity trophy ladder match. Give it about 5-6 minutes. Five. Entertainment. Yeah, minor success. Why not? Haven't announced anyone specifically right now. I'm guessing that's the video where he proposed to her. I don't know if I want to open this on stream. You're telling me you wouldn't get with Madman Pondo? How old is she? This is about a year later, so she's... It says she's 23. And just remember, she's like... This is 2017, so she's not legit 22 right now. Are you kidding me? No way. I refuse to believe that. September 10th, 1993. That's 22 years old. Didn't she get married to him in like 2013 or something? So she was like 19 years old when he... Huh. Damn. There we go. That was Matt Hardy talking about the delightful xylophone. Oh, okay, yes.
It's an extraordinary xylophone. We've been, I haven't done much in the first 40 minutes of this besides quote Matt Hardy from the final deletion. I likened it to Face Off, where it's just one of those, it's so bad it's good, and then it's so goddamn quotable. I need to get this done at some point. I need to get to my actual deal here. Let's see here. So we got the angle here. Let's do... I'm thinking we need... We'll have Dario still out here, and we'll have Marty Skrull. So, entertainment and entertainment. He's got a little bit, doesn't he? Yeah. It's a dilapidated boat! What's wrong with you? Skrull comes out and wants in the match and have his match canceled with Killings. It's refused. Just something quick there. Pondo is 47. Pondo is literally over twice her age. Just fuck. Oh my god. Alright, Jesus Christ. What should my first bit be here? Oh my god, I'm gonna go to something slightly less loud. Just so I can think for a second. Let's see. We're gonna have a match. I'm trying to figure out what it is I'm gonna have. Okay, I think what we'll start off with, let's see, Matt Cage and Yuma. We didn't really have that straight up one-on-one match, so we'll have that one-on-one match of Matt Cage versus Yuma. This does seem weird they would have met. Yeah, because she started in 2011, which was 5 years ago, so she would have been 17 when she debuted. She would have been 17 when she debuted. So you usually train for at least a few months before that, before you ever actually step into a ring. I'd say it's at least 3 months. From what I've seen, anyone who's credible, they'll give you about 3 months before they actually put you into a ring for a match. Maybe 2 months, depending on how quickly you're learning. But, yeah, either way, she had to have been 17 when she debuted. So, just the oddness there. God, let's see here. Storytelling match here. Let's see. Let's do open match. Let's do interference on Yuma by Joel Redman. That's what it was. I had to think for a second what it was going to be here. So we'll give Matt Cage the win. Which is cool, because I think Matt Cage needs a fucking win. I can't remember how his match history has been going. Okay, he won last 2 weeks ago. He doesn't usually win, though. That's the thing. Yuma, I think, recently got a win, too, so... Yeah. Well, it was a little bit ago. He won a few months back. So, yeah. Joel Redman will interfere on Matt Cage's behalf. Joel Redman will interfere on Matt Cage's behalf. He'll get, he'll help out Matt Cage get the win. So, Matt Cage, Joel Redman, Yuma, Raj Singh. Let's see.
Cajun Redman beat down Yuma. Whoops. Singh comes out dressed in rock gear for the save. I don't know how much space I got. Yeah, not enough space. But I want it to be known that, oh, he just came out in rock gear. So, I guess I'll just do selling. Selling's definitely for Yuma. Minor success for these guys. Minor success for Singh. He's probably not popular enough to actually use, say, his appeal here. Let's see. Selling. Entertainment. We'll have it be like that. Like it's not explicitly stated that, you know, he's got a bit of a he comes out, it's like the whole official start of, like, officially 2MB, because he came out in rock gear, and it's been stated over and over that these guys are kind of like an unofficial type 2MB. So, part of it's entertainment, and we'll move on with that. Oh, man, I probably should have set up a match thing in front of me. I need to remember what matches I had here. Madman Pondo calling Brother Pondo. Oh my god. I wonder if is he local? He's not. Mike Knox is, though. Buff Daddy! I'm gonna turn this down just a touch. Alright. You can ask make something weird and call Mary Dobson's sister Mary. I'm thinking I'm probably going to do something, a little something with Mary Dobson at some point. Let's see. Because she's kind of got the crazy weird thing. I thought about adding her and Katarina Lee together as faces. That's why I wanted Katarina Lee as a face. Not quite sure what I'm going to do. That's the thing. That's the weird thing about the women's roster. Is that I'm not 100% sure what I'm going to do with some of them. Like, I've got ideas. I just need to put them together. Actually, we'll do a match real quick. Let's do that. I don't really put Mary Dobson in much. We'll actually make this work. Mary Dobson... It's a promo about, Anniversary 2. There we go, and her plans. She doesn't really have many plans. That's the odd thing about this, is she's just sort of talking. She'd prefer to work without a script. Can you? We'll try it and watch you fail, but sure. This is gonna be so much fun. I cannot wait for her to fall flat on her face. I thought I could do it now. Let's see. So these are our faces, these are our heels. 5 versus 7. That's fine. We'll be fine for right now. Or I could have them feud. Hobson, goddammit. I want to put Sarah Lee in here. That seems to be the best option. Yeah, because I have something for the rest of them. We'll give them... Oh, man, I don't think they can go 10 minutes. I don't want to put 10 minutes on... Sarah Lee, she's not going to be able to work 10 fucking minutes. Let's see. Yeah, let's work the crowd. I think that would probably be the best idea here. Let's protect Sarah Lee. open match, let's do decisive pinfall finish. Or just a decisive finish. So, you know, it's a straight up just her beating her. Mary Dobson just straight up beat her. Let's see here. Mary Dobson. I may have to debut her as a heel. Hang on. I think I might be changing my mind already. Is having her come out as a heel. Could that work as a heel? Yeah, we can just leave it at that. Do a save on that real quick. The big dog, Evie, is she still dating that non-big dog? I would assume so. Dating Alex Reynolds, yep. The champion. She is the Nikki Bella of my promotion. She is dating the champion. The top guy. Alright. Let's see here. So we want Mary Dobson, Sarah Lee. Oh no. Should I involve her at all? She's just gonna suck this up. Let's just not even involve her. Mary Dobson promises to crash the anniversary. To crash anniversary 2. Anniversary 2. If she does not get on it. Let's see. What can she do? Let's do selling on both. Lead debuts for beat down. There we go. Don't compare Yugi to Nikki Bella. Low on that. And then we have a little bit of a mini feud there. I don't think they're going to have a match at Anniversary 2, though. Maybe like a promo or something. I think that would probably be the best option, is to do some sort of beatdown instead of other nonsense. Excuse me one second. Ooh. Deal with that. Alright. So, angle there. Let's see. What's the next? I'm trying to remember analysis here. What do we got? Alright. We'll do... Should I have Kenny Omega? Yeah. I'll have Kenny Omega, Tangaloa. Loa's in the back with Omega. And they cut a promo about ending Tama Tonga at Anniversary 2. There we go. Just about 3 minutes for both of them to just go nuts on the mic. Kenny Omega just being an anime villain. Match time. What should we have in here? Let's see. Lisa Marie is going to be not debuting until Anniversary. Chael Sonnen is not going to debut until Anniversary. Ethan Carter III, who's not here, is not going to debut until Anniversary. Same with Naito, and he's just doing a one-night thing anyway. Let's do a men's match here. Let's see. What can we work on here? Exclude booked. Who do we got? We'll take out a women. We'll do another women's division one here. Start a year-long build to Anniversary 3. I'm just getting ready to complete a year-long build from Anniversary 1 to Anniversary 2. So I may do something leading up to a year-long build leading up to Anniversary 3. I'm actually in the midst. We're coming to the end of a year-long build since Anniversary 1. So absolutely will be done. Oh, let's do the Kushida thing. We can get that out of the way. Let's see here. Is there a heel for him to go up against? Let's see. Carino. I don't have anything for Carino at Anniversary, do I? Let's do Lance and Noi. We'll do that. I don't think I've had these two face each other yet. Yes, I did. Back in July. That's alright. That was 2 months ago. Let them go at it again. About 9 minutes. So who's the top star? Technically, my heavyweight champion right now is Alex Reynolds, as far as top stars are concerned. More mainstream guys like Matt Hardy, Raj Singh, the former Jinder Mahal. Kenny Omega, I think, would be another one, too. But right now, Alex Reynolds is my heavyweight champion. Kushida just doing his thing here. We'll protect Lance and Noai, because he's not the best at, wrestling. Decisive win, I guess. You know what? Actually, we'll do, not a DQ. Yeah, we'll do a DQ. No. I'm trying to figure out how I want to do this. Intentional countout. How about that? Alright. Oh, Kushida can't talk. Fuck. I just remembered that. Oh, we'll have Dario come out and talk for him. That's what I'll do. Entertainment, and he'll just stand there and... Why am I checking this? Yeah, of course he can't. You know what? He just got done with a match. We'll have him sell. Let's see. Dario comes out and informs Kushida that Tozawa will not be at Anniversary 2, but he'll find something. Let me see. Dario informs Tozawa. Informs Kushida that Tozawa won't be, but he'll have something for him. I don't know what. We'll have something for Kushida instead of Tozawa. That's a last second thing too. I already made the graphic and everything. Who would technically be considered my top star? My main event stars: Kushida, Matt Hardy, the not yet debuting Ethan Carter III, and Alex Reynolds. So Raj Singh moves down to upper mid card, as does Ron Killings and Tama Tonga. So there's my top four main event stars. Let's see here. Let's see, let's have Ron Killings come out. He'll be flanked by, of course, Io and Mayu. Entertainment. Stand there, look pretty, because you guys can't talk. Line of success is all around. Freedom come out. And discuss the end of Degeneration Dash and Anniversary 2. We can just have it like that. Give it about probably 6 minutes, because Io Shirai is also part of the women's deal as well. So let's see here. Let's do Ron Killings, Marty Skrull, Io Shirai, Mayu Iwatani, Dash Chisako, and maybe bring someone else out too. I feel like somebody else should be a part of this. I'm gonna have Kimberly come out with Degeneration Dash. That'll be it there. Degeneration Dash. Come out with Kimberly. To face Freedom. In a six-man tag. I don't think I've done an intergender tag match yet, so I hope they'll actually let me do it. Entertainment. Once again, I'm just going to have to use Sex Appeal for these three, because they don't know English, and pretty much everything else requires English. We'll just do Minor Success all around, because you know what, this will be kind of a big deal, I think. Maybe. About 3 minutes, I'd say. Hopefully they'll allow me to do this. I guess we'll find out. Alright, so we'll do Ron Killings. And Io Shirai. And Mayu Iwatani. The three remaining members of Threedom right now versus Marty Skrull. And Dash Chisako. Oh, come on. And, oh god, I already clicked on it. Kimberly. Degeneration Dash. There we go. Threedom versus Degeneration Dash and Kimberly. This is kind of the first time we've actually had them all together. It'll give them like 14 minutes to kind of do something here. Oh man. Let's see. You know what? We're gonna leave this as storytelling right now. Open match. I don't even know how I'm going to book this. Let's see. Who's going to win this? Shit. Ooh, you know what? Let's have Kimberly get the win. So, not anyone officially from either Threedom or Degeneration Dash get the win. And the loser of this will be Mayu Iwatani. Because neither one of them are technically here for that. Io's kept strong. Dash is kept strong. Alright, are you going to let me do this? Awesome. A mixed six-man tag. Awesome. Wasn't 100% sure if they're going to let me do that, because there's the whole separate division, and there's, like, usually sometimes it depends on if it's the whole integrated deal or if it's like a whole separate division. I didn't know if they're going to allow me to do it, but hey, I managed to get a six-man tag out of this. Nice. We're 81 minutes in. We're 59% matches, which is fine because our main event's going to take a little bit of time too. And I know I'm going to do 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to do at least one more match after this, between this and the Battle Royal. All right. We're going to talk to a couple people in the Battle Royal. Let's see. Who could use some mic time? Who could use a little bit of mic time? Let's see. Colby Carino. He's getting there. Let's give him a shot. Let's just throw him out. Let's just have him in the back. Talking about the Battle Royal. Give him like a minute. That's all I need. Entertainment, minor success. We'll do like three of these 1 minute long segments. Who else should be a part of this who isn't already in the match? Oh, Patrick Clark. The guy that Matt Hardy said was terrible and I should boot him immediately. Let's see. Dobson, Sherman, Kushida, Kenny Omega, Juice. I haven't done anything with Juice yet. Entertainment, minor success. Juice is in the back as well, discussing his chances at winning the battle royale. Oh shit, I already have him in, don't I? He already won a match, didn't he? I just remember, as I was done typing that, I'm like, oh yeah, he kinda already won, if I remember right. Let's do Bolt Brady then. I think Bolt Brady hasn't really done much of that. So we'll do Bolt there. I was gonna do Cody Hall, but I might just leave it for something else. Let's see. I'm trying to think if there's anything else. How about this? I just realized I could do Pete Dunne. Now, Pete Dunne's already technically got a match lined up. But we'll give him a chance on the mic, which doesn't seem like it's going to work out the best, but we'll just do it anyway. He's ready to pull double duty in 2 weeks at Anniversary 2. There we go. Alright, match. Alright, we need Alex Reynolds. Was it Alex Reynolds or Mark Sherman that had their match last time? Let's see, Alex Reynolds beat Rick Steiner. I forgot about that. So let's have someone for, Sherman to beat. I'm almost thinking Alex Kozlov, because that would probably actually be pretty cool. I'm thinking it might be. He can work. I think he could do pretty well. I'm trying to see if there's anyone else. Brent Albright. Wasn't he like a big Ring of Honor type guy? Gunner Scott. I remember him as Gunner Scott on SmackDown. Don Harris. Oh, man. Who do I want to have him go up against? I could keep the running gag of Hardcore Homo Angel, but I don't think I want to keep that running gag going right this second. Cage. Lodi. Lodi's technically an active wrestler? What the... Just bring back old school WCW for this shit. He really couldn't go in the ring, could he? I'm just gonna take an assumption on no. Yeah, no. Let's see. Nick Steiner, Sam Fatu. God. Bring back Tadarius Thomas for a night. That might be interesting, to say the least. I don't know. Is he all that skilled? He's not really all that skilled. Trevor Murdoch? Trevor Murdoch might be kind of fun. He can sort of work. I think Alex Kozlov would be cool. Let's see how much Alex Kozlov charges. 5'10"? Alright. Show up. Show up for a night, Kozlov. We will use you. We'll make you occasional wrestler. There you go. Heal, that works. We don't even need a gimmick for him. He's just one appearance. There we go. One-on-one. So, Mark Sherman taking on Alex Kozlov in his tune-up match for his title. For his title match in 2 weeks. I think they could probably go at least 10 minutes. I think these could go... These guys could probably go about 12. Could either one of them... Does either one of them have something that I could work off of? Not really. Mark Sherman, mostly. I think Alex Kozlov might have some... Yeah, he's got chain, a little bit of chain wrestling and such, but we'll just leave that as that right there. Victor, Mark Sherman... Making an open match. Decisive win. There we go. It's kind of a just a tune-up throwaway match like we did with Alex Reynolds and Rick Steiner. And then Alex Reynolds, Mark Sherman, Reynolds blindside Sherman, and stands over him with the belt. Kind of like 2 weeks, 2 weeks before that when Sherman ended the night with like that. So there's a little bit of a deal there. So selling on both, we'll do minor success at least for Reynolds. I guess there's not really much of an injury risk at all with that. All right, so that was that angle, and then. Man, that battle royal. Let's see. I guess one more guy who can maybe discuss this. Well, actually, someone should come out to do commentary. Who can come out and do color? One of these guys should be able to come out and do color with Bischoff. One of the guys who's already in the match. Omega? Omega's already there tonight. C-minus, it's not bad. Big O is in there too. He can do color. Let's give Big O a shot. Fuck it. We haven't seen Big O yet. The Big O comes out and is set to join Bischoff at the announce table. There we go. Just a couple minutes there. Entertainment. Eric Bischoff, he can have a little bit of entertainment there too. Da, 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 da. Take him off the announcer position because he's part of the angle. There we go. Alright. Battle Royal. 10. Oh man. Can we fill 10 men? That sounded awful. Bolt Brady, he's not in. Colby Carino. God, who else isn't in? Matt Hardy. Patrick Clark. Pete Dunne. Let's see. Raj Singh. Juice, Joel Redman, Katrina Lee. Let's see. Heel, heel, face, heel, face, face. I did want to make this kind of interesting, so what I'm going to actually do is I'm going to make Evie and Jessica Havoc two people in this match as, like, surprise entrance. Havoc could probably wreck house. I don't know so much about Evie, but we'll work with that, I think. Let's see here. Big O's already in. Tama Tonga will go in along with Tangaloa. Even though they're technically set to have a cage match, you know. I guess that kind of gives away the fact that they're not going to win. Okay. So So it is a 10-person over the top rope. Over the top rope battle royal for final spot in opportunity trophy match. There we go. Give it about 20 minutes, I'd say. Whole lot of storytelling would be going on here. The winner of this is Matt Hardy. Let's see. A lot of keep strong here. Let's see. We can keep Tama Tonga strong. Oh god, who should be the runner-up here? Oh, someone should be the runner-up. Who should be the runner-up? Pete Dunne. Pete Dunne is going to be the runner-up. This is a guy we're going to definitely... Part of me really wants Jessica Havoc to be the one with the most eliminations. Gets rid of, like, Evie and then maybe Bolt Brady and Colby Green. Havoc is going to have the most eliminations. Fuck it. Let's do this. See if that helps. Over the course of this, we're going to have Jessica Havoc get interference by Super Young. Tama Tonga is going to get interference via Kenny Omega. Let's see, who else? I think that's about it for the attacking of people. Raj Singh is going to get attacked by Joel Redman. I think that's just about it for those people there. Alright, I think that's just about it there. So Matt Hardy wins in storytelling. Tama Tonga's kept strong. Probably not a finalist. Pete Dunne will be one of the finalists. It'll come down to Matt Hardy and Pete Dunne. Jessica Havoc will have the most eliminations. She'd probably be like third. The third eliminated. Probably by Sue Young doing something. So we'll see how well this works out. I don't know how well this is going to work out. But we'll see. Let's see, we'll do Matt Hardy, the Big O. Let's do Pete Dunne, Kenny Omega, Tangaloa. Hall wasn't in here, so we'll not have it be Pete Dunne. We'll just do Kenny Omega, Tangaloa. Let's see here. It probably should be Tama Tonga, actually. There we go. So selling for everybody. This is how we're going to end the go-home here. It's all pretty much neutral as far as these guys fighting each other. Oh, you know what? Because of this, Cody Hall will come out, and then we have the Big O come down. So everyone is selling. Let's see. Omega and Loa beat on Tama, Hardy saves them. Hall comes out to help BC Bullet Club. Runs down show ends. I was gonna put show ending brawl. Just a show-ending brawl between six different people. And that's how I'll end it. Boom. And that should be good enough right there. I think that's about the best I'm going to do right now. Alright, I think I've hit just about everything right now. I think I hit just about everything that I'm going to need to be hitting. So, I guess I got no choice but to run the show, and we'll see how well it all works. Dark Dakota opens up the show to announce the Battle Royal. D+, solid start. Another D+ here for Quaito and Skrull. Skrull, of course, wanting to be a part of the Battle Royal. Not going to happen because he's got his last man standing match with Ron Killings at Anniversary 2. Matt Cage and Yuma had their kind of bout. Yuma's not really holding up as much as I'd like him to. I've already had some plans, and that might just keep the plans rolling as far as Yuma not being here past Anniversary. Matt Cage, Joel Redman, Yuma, Raj Singh. Cage and Redman beat down Yuma. Singh comes out dressed in rock gear for the save to kind of officially say, hey, I'm here for 2MB. Perfect. Sets up that tag match that we've already, I believe, booked. I believe we booked it. Did we? Yes, 2MB versus Matt Cage and Alex Reynolds, Mark Sherman, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Cool. Most of the matches are booked already, so. Let's see, Mary Dobson cutting a promo there. She faces Sarah Lee in a shit performance because neither one of them are all that great. But Katarina Lee comes in and debuts, and she's already gotten a great, and she's getting better at her gimmick, and it's got high praise with a C, which is good, because it looks like I'm going to be hitting a D for this show, unless things start picking up, which already seems to be picking up a little bit. Omega and Tangaloa talking about ending Tamatonga at Anniversary 2. Kushida and Lance Inouye. Lance Inouye actually surprisingly got a 40 out of him, which is actually pretty damn good. I didn't think that was going to happen. Of course, it's then announced that, Akira Tozawa is not going to be there for Anniversary 2. We'll have to find something for Kushida. I'm not 100% sure what, but we'll find something. Threedom doing their whole deal of discussing Anniversary 2. Of course, Ron Killings with his last man standing match. Io Shirai with her women's title match. And then, of course, D-Generation Dash and Kimberly come out because there's going to be an impromptu six-person tag, which I don't know how well this is going to turn out. Cross your fingers. Pretty nice, actually. 59. Not too bad. Kimberly kind of held down the whole thing there. Mayu Iwatani actually did quite a bit better. Everyone else did quite well, especially Io Shirai. Dude, I'm banking so much. This is a year-long deal with this HPW women's storyline. This is a year-long deal that's going to culminate at Anniversary 2. I'm fully expecting Io Shirai and Dash Shisako to tear the fucking house down. I'm fully expecting it. Colby Carino can't really talk. Neither can Bolt Brady. Pete Dunne a little bit more so. Alex Kozlov did okay, honestly. He didn't do all that bad in comparison. Maybe I should grab him instead of Bolt Brady. Can't remember how much I'm paying Bolt Brady, but if I can get Alex Kozlov for about the same amount, maybe I should look into that instead. 56, though, is quite nice for Mark Sherman, Alex Kozlov. Alex Reynolds, Mark Sherman, of course, Alex Reynolds kind of standing over Sherman with the belt, and there's your official heavyweight title pre-booking deal. Big O comes to join Eric Bischoff, which I forgot to make him the color guy. Fuck, I just remembered that. Damn it, I'm dumb. And I'm sure someone's going to mention that in my comments, where they're just like, you forgot to put Big O with the color commentary. I'm like, I know, I forgot. Whoops. A 60, actually. For that match, not all that bad, really. Rush Singh's getting better at his gimmick. Tama Tonga's not suited to his. Bolt Brady's not really suited to his. Good for Patrick Clark for ending up it probably would have been better if I didn't have Patrick Clark in there or Bolt Brady. But hey, it would seem to work out pretty well. A C, 60. It's quite nice for the ending there. And then, of course, the show-ending brawl that's kind of mixing at least two different feuds together. To end the show, and that will be the end there. 62, that's quite nice. I can't remember if that's one of my best shows that I've put on so far, actually. It's actually quite consistent. It got pretty consistent towards the end there. Of course, the ending bit tends to, I believe, weight the rest of it, so... Let's see, who did really well? Oh no, you know who's got some issues? We'll compliment him on a good performance. We'll try to not piss off the other people so much here. So Sue Young will be complimented. We're gonna try to make people just a little bit happier by complimenting them. Cool. I don't want them to be so pissy at me. Don Fuji! He's great in Dragon Gate. I need something to drink real quick. Fucking A, there it is, boys. We are finally a regional promotion. It only took us a year. It took us a year to go from local to small, and by doing two shows a month, we went from small to regional in the course of a year. And I think... You know what's the dumbest thing about this? I actually, because I was drinking this Kickstart, I'm actually raising it in the air as if I'm toasting to you guys. You guys can't even see it, nor are you in front of me, but I'm toasting to, like, my TV. The fact that I've risen to regional size. So just imagine me holding my drink up towards the TV, and you guys can hold yours up towards the computer monitor. Or not, because that'd probably be pretty cringy. But we finally moved up to regional size. I'm so happy about that. Tomatonga's feeling the effects of a grueling schedule. You better heal up in 2 weeks, motherfucker. You better heal up in 2 weeks, motherfucker. You both have got a cage match against each other. Infamous importance. After the last show, Infamous has had a rise in importance. We're now an above-average event. Fucking A, man. We are making it. Above average in importance. You know what? That means we're going to have even more people start showing up. I cannot wait. Because we're going to have to start looking for bigger buildings here soon. We'll get to find out for anniversary just how much people an average importance event draws in. That is fucking awesome. Infamous 34 got a .02, so that's quite good. I like what Mark Sherman's doing in the ring. The kid is only going to get better with time. Good. I'm glad that Matt Hardy feels that that is going to be a thing, because guess what's going to happen in 2 weeks? I've entered a one-month grace period after rising in size. While this phase is in effect, the company is immune to popularity loss from regional battle defeats. Actually, to be completely fair, that's kind of why I took all that out. That's one of the few things that I turned off, if I remember right, was company battles. While it could be a good thing, it just wasn't a thing that was going to help me. Like, it's one of those things where I'm like, oh, wow, okay, so... What's after regional? Cult. Cult is after regional. And once you hit regional, or I'm trying to remember who all's technically cult. I think cult promotions are like TNA. TNA is a cult promotion. Ring of Honor. Oh, Ring of Honor is only regional. Jesus. TNA's cult. I think New Japan. New Japan's national. Who could be cult? If New Japan's national, then Dragon Gate's definitely cult. Yeah, Dragon Gate's cult. I bet you there's... I could probably do that. Let's see. Up next would be cult, and those are promotions like All Japan, Dragon Gate, the goddamn Hulkamania Federation, NOAH, and TNA. Right now, as a regional promotion, I get to be considered on the same level as Big Japan, DDT... Evolve, FIP, Global Force, House of Hardcore, ICW. ICW, that's kind of cool. Kaientai Dojo. Kaientai Dojo, I don't feel, should be regional. Lucha Underground. Of course, I'm 45th or something, I think, and they're 25th. So, Lance Storm made it into the Hall of Fame. That is amazing. HPW is rising fast. Now is a very dangerous time for the next few months. They must walk the fine line between confidence and overconfidence as they look to capitalize on their current success without overreacting and overreaching and damaging their own long-term prospects. What is that going to do with my... I'd love to know what that's technically going to do to my prospects here. I don't really know exactly what that's going to do. If that changes a lot of my roster. Minimum number of wrestlers is 20. I have 37, so I am nowhere close to being at a minimum. by the way, how much did that cost me the whole way? I lost $2,000 since the start of the month, so not bad, I guess. I spent $24,000, so I'm hopefully going to spend a little bit less. Production is already about what it was last month, so it's going to be almost twice what it was because I had to change to professional to keep my grades up. Fuck, who was the person to do that? I'm going to have to look back into this stream and just give a nice flip-off bird to the person who upped their production values. What? No, wait, huh? Oh my god. Oh, that's right, I'm regional now. Oh no. Oh, fuck-a-roni. Well... That's right. I just remembered, I'm regional now, so I have a whole new set of people. So now I have to compete with Lucha Underground, NXT, Ring of Honor for production values. I fucking hate you guys. This is gonna suck. Oh, man. Yeah, it's regional, then cult, and then national. So national comes after cult, but I think it's going to be a while before I see cult, because I need 47% importance in two regions, and right now, spillover is not enough to make that a thing. I'm not running shows outside of the Midwest right now, so I'll probably just work on building myself up and pretty much maxing myself out in the Midwest, and then I'll look into reaching in other places. I think is how I'm going to do it. Oh, fuck. I can't afford to just up it like that. I'm going to have to keep it where it's at and suffer the small loss. Because I know you'll take a small hit if your production values are not up with everybody else's. Which sucks, because I think... Yeah, that was my best show so far that I've put on. 31 was a 60. And this was a 62, so... Yeah. Alright. Oh, man. Alright, so I'll end the video part here for the people on YouTube. For the people on the stream, of course, I'm going to be booking the anniversary show, 13 days, I believe, is what I'm going to... I think I'm going to keep it that way. Let's see who's gone. I think I actually might change the day. We'll find out. But either way, for the people who watch this on YouTube, thank you very much. I will, you know, of course, cut this here, and then the next video will be, of course, the anniversary 2 show, and that'll be a whole big deal there, and I cannot wait to book that. I'm thinking, because I have the match cards ready, I'm not sure if I want to do that now, or if I want to do that at the beginning of the next one. I might do that towards the beginning of the next one, so we'll do that, because you never know what'll happen within the next 13 days. Alright, so you guys on stream, sit tight. I'll be doing that in just a second. You guys on YouTube, thank you. I'll see you guys next time.